Now, guys, what we are going to discuss is database. Okay, so for developers, this is a very important topics, though very limited work we have. Like we want to create a database, we want to use the database, and we want to backup a database. These are the primary things we do that. And it's a platform as a service. Okay, so here, look at this. Initially, we understood that AWS global infrastructure, including regions and availability zone. Then networking, we have still not completed. Compute, we have done it. Storage, we have done it. Now database. So what are the options we have here in database? So we have a multiple options. We have RDS, we have DynamoDB, we have Elastic Cache, we have RepSift, and some migration tools also. So today we'll discuss many of this stuff, but we'll focus on the RDS, and as part of the demo, we'll keep the RDS in it. So what is RDS? So I think most of you must be working on certain database. Which are the database you guys are working? Can you please name it here? If you are using Postgres, that means it's RDS, DynamoDB, which is basically NoSQL. So yes, here AWS supports all sort of database you have in front of you: MySQL, Oracle, MSQL, PostgreSQL, Aurora, and any custom database also it can help you. By the way, this is a platform as a service. So if you want to set up your own database and control the runtime environment, what you do, you get a EC2 instance and install the database servers and then manage your database. That's the one way to do that. But here, runtime is managed by them, not by you. You are only taking care of the database. So please remember that. So yes, it's a simple and faster to deploy. Manages common database administrative task. So that means no database administrator you need to hire for now. Compatible with your applications. Okay. Fast, predictable, and performance. Simple and fast to scale, and secure and cost effective. Now there are some characteristics which you need to understand. So database engine managed by AWS, which I have stated a few times. Now supported one MySQL, Oracle, MSQL, PostgreSQL, Maria, and Amazon Aurora. By the way, Amazon Aurora, MariaDB, and MySQL all are same engine actually, more or less with little bit of modifications. Multi-stage deployment options are available, so you can deploy in the multi-stages. It can be on-demand and reserved instance pricing is possible. On-demand, you know that it will be a little costlier. Reserved pricing, reserved instance, if you go for that, then you can save up to 60% of the cost. Again, you can define the storage type of those database, magnetic, SSDs, provision IOPS and all. Again, if you have your own license, that is possible. Bring your licensing is possible here. BYOL scheme. And automated and manual backups are available. Here, in terms of automated backups, understand that continuously track changes and backups your database when you set up automated. Volume snapshot of your entire DB instance is just not a DBs. Okay, volume snapshot of entire DB instance. One day of backup retained by default, but can be configured up to the 35 days. A backup retention period defined during configurations. When you delete an RDN instance, all automated snapshots are deleted. Manual snapshots are preserved. So you have to remember this one, very important one. So when you delete the RDS instance, automated snapshot also will be deleted. Now, automated backups occur daily during 30 minutes configurable backup window. That means you can decide when the automated backup should run, but it will be taking in a duration of 30 minutes and do the rest of the things. Automated backups are preserved for a configurable number of days retention period. Now, RDS store, restore. So this is the backup. What is the process and characteristics of restore? You can restore from a DB snapshot to an existing DB instance. A new DB instance is created when you restore. Only default DB parameters and security groups are restored. You must manually associate all other DB parameters and SCs, security groups. RDS combine a daily backup in conjunction with transaction log to restore the DB instance to any point during the retention period and up to the last 5 minutes. So, yep. You can also create a multi-ages failover. So multi-ages RDS deployment design for aging is possible using this. Synchronous replicas in secondary is easy, automatically happen. Standby replicas, RDS is invisible. So let's say if you have a failover created, so one will be always available and standby will be always invisible. So you don't have to worry about it. And automatically they will sync each other. So that also you don't have to take care of it. DB snapshots are always taken against standby instance. That means when the backup happens, it always runs against the running instance, against the standby instance, which is not running. AWS automatically adjusted DNS record when needed. Multi-age is different from RDS read replicas. Okay, so here you see that here there's a master database and then standby database, and both are in sync. So backup is always done with the standby and master is been served for the purpose. Now the moment you start the backup, standby updated backup maintenance done, and then automated DMS DNS change happen with the master. So when the backup happens, standby will become a master and master will become a standby, and then we'll do the changes. All these changes happen, DNS changes happen automatically. And you can create a read replicas from masters also, only for the reading purpose, so that you can design. So read RDS read replicas. So here, read replicas designed for workload sharing offloading, created from a snapshot of a master instance. A synchronous replication, read only connections, and read only disaster. Okay, so what are the things we have to opt for it while deploying the RDS reserved instance? DV engine, DV instance class, deployment type, licensing model, and region. These are the things you have to do that. Now I'm going to create a on-demand instance. So reserved instance will be little cheaper, but you have to pay for it for the entire duration, 1 year or 2 years, like that. Okay. So now coming back to the DV instance, DV instances are the basic building blocks of Amazon RDS. That means DV instance means you can say one database. They are on isolated database environment in the cloud. They can contain multiple user created database. So backups, automated and manual snapshots, you can set it up. Okay, cross region snapshots also possible. So are a copy of a database snapshot stored in a different database region, provide a backup for disasters recovery, can be used as a base for migration to a different region. There are some security also which is implemented at the RDS level. So VPC security anyways is there. Now VPC, which I have not discussed so far, so it's pending, we'll discuss. IAM policy we discussed, you can apply that. Security groups, you know that. SSL secure socket layer, you can implement the connection to the DB instances. You can encrypt it also. Snapshot also, you can control access. And database also, you can set up a control access and stuff like that. So many security related things you can do that. Now, this is a typical architecture. When you plan, you should plan for it. So here you see that load balancers, balancing the EC2 instance, and then EC2 instance is hitting to the database, and part of the database, maybe your DB snapshot is in S3. Snapshot always, you can keep it in S3 for the lowering cost. So this is the stuff. With multi-AGS operations, do your database seamlessly replicate it to another availability zone in same AWS region? Failover to the standby automatically occurs in case of master database failure. Plan maintenance is applied first to standby database. Okay, so here a resilient durable application architecture or something similar to you can create. I showed you last also. Some of the best practices in while working the database, monitor your memory, CPU and storage uses. Use multi-AGS deployment to automatically provision and maintain a synchronous standby in a different availability zone. Enable automatic backups. Set the backup window to occur during the daily loop in write-ops. To increase the IO input IO capacity of the DB instance, migrate to a DB instance class with high IO input capacity. Convert from standard storage to provision IOPS storage and use a DB instance class optimized for provision IOPS and provision additional throughput capacity if using provision IOPS storage. Test failover for your DB instance. So these are the some of the best practices. Okay, so now I'll just move on to the demo. Yeah. During the creation of database, that you can decide what kind of type of CPU and what is the type of type means CPU and RAM and then storage also. So there you can configure everything and then basically understand that just you need to define the compute resources and on top of that engine will be managed by AWS. So in okay, so for this AWS cannot do that. For that you have to take one little bit of testing process of your applications. So typically this is done in the ops team. Actually, we call it a capacity planning phase. And in that, what you guys, I mean, testing team and ops team, they will do. They'll set up servers, okay, and then they will create a fake load of insertion, creations, deletion, reading the database things through some testing tools like JMeter or Selenium or something like that. And they will keep increasing the load on your applications and keep reading and writing whatever it is scenarios. And then they'll tell you, okay, this is the benchmark for it. And accordingly, you will go and select this AWS. AWS will not interfere in this stuff. Yes. You can do that. Yeah, that you can do that. If you want to increase the type or different storage, you can take up a backup. From the backup, you can restore it, and that is possible. Okay, so let me show you the demo. So this is here. Okay, I think I disable the share. Okay, so are you able to see my screen? Okay, now I'm going to assign the access. So what access? Why I'm not assigning all access in one go? That way you'll understand that which policy is required for which places. So this is the user group, and here I'm going to set the permission. So here you need the RDS permissions, and here enter. So now here RDS full, I'm giving it, and add permissions, done. Now here I will use this account. Now I'll go to are you able to see screen, right? So go to the databases. Here it is. It's a category, and inside that you have so many databases which is supported. Now the one which I'm talking about is RDS. Okay, now for the demo sake, we'll go for the Aura database, because for others you required license and the cost is too high, but the creation process is almost same. Now if you see that how many instances we have, 0 by 40, that means my capacity is up to 40 database I can create, instance of database I can create. So yep, these are the subnet VPC, you know, I'll just go with the default VPC subnet. So go ahead and create a database, and just follow this, close this. So now here you want to create standard create or easy create, more or less it's the same thing. Little bit of time will be saved here, but I'll go for standard create. Now here you have to decide which database you want. So you go for Aura. It's again based on the SQL, open source SQL. MySQL is also based on the open source SQL, MySQL. Now MySQL is owned by now, I think, Oracle itself. Oracle, again, we have MariaDB, we have PostgreSQL, we have. So whichever you want, you can go for it. So now this I'm going for it, or maybe you should go for MySQL or something like that. And it's community version I'm going for. So go for MySQL or maybe PostgreSQL if you want. Let's say you have to select which PostgreSQL you wanted. So for this demo, I'm going for, let's say, MySQL and community edition. Now, which version of MySQL I want? I'll just stick to the whatever the latest is there. Now, they're asking you whether you want for production or test or some free tier. So you have to select this one. Right now, I'll just, let's say, I'll go for dev and testing purpose. It's not having too much of differences. It's just few parameters they will give you to you extra, so you can make it production ready. Here, what you want: availability and durability. So, do you want this database to be replicated? So, or this cluster to be created? So, if you want the cluster to be created, then you can go for it. If you want the multi-AJS instance, then you can go for this. Right now, these all are out of scope, and we'll just go with a single DB instance. Now, what is the name of the database? This is the one. So remember that any application, they require four information, which I must write it here. So first thing, they required the DB host. Second thing they required is username. Third thing, password. And fourth thing, anyone idea? Guys, are you able to hear me? So username, password, host address, one thing port, and one more thing which is pending, database. So if you have a five information, then that is what application needs it. Am I correct? All of you? Hello? So port number, I will tell you, 3306 is a MySQL default. Now, so yes, this is the name of the database, instance identifier. Now, what is the master username for it? And here, do you want to generate a password? You want to keep it? I just want to generate a password. Okay, so auto-generated a password, which I'll get at the end of it. So see here, Amazon RDS can generate a password for you, or you can specify your own password. So auto-generated password. Now here you only have to select this instance class. Guys, all of you see that screen, right? So when you want to try it out for the demo purpose, for the learning purpose, you should see that by default, it is coming with a 2 CPU, 8 GB RAM. Correct now, all of you? So you should not go for it. This is just a waste of resources for learning. You should downgrade and you should go for, let's say, something like, I'll just select, I'll just tell you, you should go for something like, where is that? Just a second. T options I'm not getting. See here, burstable classes, this one. And I want, see here, this one. So don't go for this higher one. It's just a waste of money, you know. Standard class, because you're not using for the production purpose and all. But you know, you can specify, you see that here, 32 CPU, 120 GB RAM, all these things you can select here. But right now, why to waste money? So memory also, if you go for memory optimized, you'll get a very high memory, you know, 512 GB of RAM. And here you see 64 GB of RAM and stuff like that. So it depends on that. These are standard classes. This is a memory optimized classes. This is the burstable classes which you can use for the learning. Now I'll go for the 2 CPU, 1 GB RAM. That is more than sufficient for the demo. In fact, 2 CPU, 1 GB RAM can hold up to the at least 5,000 people traffic easily. So it's like that. Now here, this is the instance configurations. Now here you can decide the storage of it. Now again, multiple options are there. I'll just go for here and allocated storage 20 GB. This is okay for 10 GB. Okay, so that is the stuff. Now what is the auto scaling? So if you want to enable the auto scaling automatically, then you have to select this. By default is there. So here you see this, provide a dynamic scaling support for your database storage based on your application's need. Here, enable storage auto scale, enable storage auto scaling. Enabling this feature will allow the storage to increase after the specified threshold is exceeded. So here, maximum threshold which you are doing is for it, storage is 100 means almost 1 TB, close to 1 TB. You can go up to 16 TB also. But right now, just 50 GB is okay for the demo. And connectivity. So connectivity means which VPC this has to be created for you. So right now, I'll just go to the default VPC and the default subnet. And do you want this to be accessible publicly? If you want to use inside it, then say no. If you want to use it from outside, from anywhere, yes. So here, yes, I'm doing it from my because I want to access from outside. And here, security groups, I'll let it be default. Remember the security groups, you have to open which port number? Anyone have idea which port number? All of you? Guys, are you there? Hello? So you have to open up in the security group this port number. 3306. If you are using MySQL, then 3306. If you are using other one, then you have to also check the default one. Availability zone, no preference, let it be. Now, how do you authenticate the database? Password authentications. You can enable password and IAM database authentications also. You can do the password and keyboard authentications also. And this is your charges. So whatever I'm creating, this will cost 13.98 USD. Okay, so everything got it, and the only request to all of you, do select this type here and storage very carefully. Don't go for higher one. I hope all of you get it, and then finally create it. That's all. See here. Now here is saying, hey, IAM user training is not authorized to perform a create role on resources IAM and blah, blah, blah. So this is the permission issues. So what I'm going to do, IAM create role. So basically, this is creating one role. So for that, I should go and add permission and IAM add permissions. And now go here and create it. And it will take 10 to 15 minutes to get you all this information. So remember all this information I needed for my applications. This all information. And this is database one. Right now it's creating. It will take 10 minutes to 15 minutes to get it done. Now, once this creation is successful, then I will gather all this information and start using for my applications. All of you understood now? So some of the information you must be getting now itself. For example, let me say configurations. And here your instance ID is this one. And still is creating many things actually. Okay, connectivity and security. Endpoint should be host, port number, and all this stuff is here. Let it come actually. It will come and then you can use it. Publicly accessible, yes. This has to be enabled. So guys, did you understand that all of you? How to get it? Okay, so it will take 10 to 15 minutes in between. You can also do that. So create one of your database. Make sure that type and other stuff is lower. And then I'll give you 10 minutes and then get one. Go ahead, guys. It's your time.
Hello everyone, if you would like to access the remaining videos of this playlist or 50 plus more tools which are coming under DevOps, DevSecOps, SRE, DataOps, GitOps, etc. Kindly become our channel members by clicking on the joining button. You would have access to 100s of playlists and 1000s of videos lifetime access with this membership. Enjoy.
Thanks for watching. Want to study further? Join our training programs today.